We will call Mr. Mark Woolander, please, Sam.
Mark Woolander. Do you swear or affirm the testimony given to you will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, sir?
I do.
Your Honor, have a seat. The witness stand.
Please state your name for the record.
Mark Woolander.
And Mr. Woolander, what do you do for a living?
I am semi-retired from the federal government. I'm a lawyer.
Okay. And what kind of law do you practice now?
A little bit of everything. I do a little bit of criminal defense work over federal court, do a little bit of civil litigation, and do a little, probably more pro bono work than I do anything.
And prior, you said you were semi-retired. What did you retire from?
You want me to go all the way back in time and give you a little bit of history, or just briefly?
Brief history.
Okay, brief history. I got out of the military in 1979, finished my undergraduate degree, went on to law school, finished up law school in 1983, stayed at the Public Defender's Office for a short period of time, became a FBI special agent, was in Dallas, then moved to FBI headquarters. 1990, I resigned from the Bureau, took over as a countywide narcotics strike force director up in Ohio, left in the end of 1990, came down here to Lexington in 1990, and was a federal prosecutor for 17 years. It's 2007, I retired. Here I am today.
And in the summer of 2014, were you aware of Mr. Price's death?
I did have some information, was aware of Mr. Price's death, you know, this matter.
Okay. And can you describe without getting into the content of the information, how did you come to learn that information?
Very basically, without going into any of the content of the information, in the beginning of July, I think July 6th or July 7th, a lady appeared at my office. She was sent there by somebody from the U.S. Attorney's Office. I can't remember who that was. I had a conversation with the lady. She provided me some information. I then took that information, and I believe it was July 7th of 2014. I sent that information on to Ron Walker, who's an assistant United States attorney, and asked him to provide it to whatever he needed to provide it. And that's generally what happened.
Do you often pass information along to prosecutors, law enforcement agents?
Been doing it for years. In fact, I like to say that I get a lot of people that show up at my office that are referred to me by my old colleagues at the U.S. Attorney's Office to see whether or not I can help them. So it's not unusual. And yes, I provide information all the time. You know, I go by the saying, if you have information, provide it and see where it goes from there.
So after that information was provided to, I believe you said it was Ron Walker?
That's correct.
And that's a federal prosecutor here in Lexington?
It is. In fact, he's now the chief of the criminal division of the U.S. Attorney's Office.
Okay. Was there ever a meeting with your client and law enforcement officers about the information that she gave you, that you're aware of?
I want to define it a little bit more. We never had an attorney-client relationship. It was a matter of, would you meet with this lady, would you talk to her, and then would you pass this information on? We never got to the next stage of me being in a relationship with her because I was never contacted after that email, July of 2014, until I was contacted within the last couple of months.
So you were never asked to facilitate a meeting with this woman and law enforcement officers?
Never heard another word back after my email to Mr. Walker.
And just to be clear, the information that you relayed had to do with Mr. Price's death?
It specifically had to do with this matter. Yes.
I didn't know if Mr. Tracy had any questions.
But Mr. Wallinger, my name is Kane Webster. I don't think we've ever met before.
No, I believe we have.
I just have a few questions for you. And I think you said back July 2014, you sent this information along to Ron Walker. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. But you didn't take part in any sit-down interview at that time?
never sat down at bedtime or any time afterwards.
Okay. You were contacted by a detective in this case?
Just recently.
Okay.
Within the last couple of days, when I say recently, I was never contacted at that time that I'm aware of.
Sure. But somebody did follow up with you?
Recently.
Okay. And without saying the information that you provided, I think you referred to this person as your client, is that correct?
No, I said that this lady came to my office and we never got to the point of her being a client. She came to me with the information. She was sent to me by somebody, and I can't even remember who from the U.S. Attorney's Office referred to me, and they wanted me to talk to her because of some concerns she had.
Sure. But if you had written in the email that she was your client, would that be correct?
I don't have the email in front of me, but if I would have said client, I would have been referring it to a generic sense, not attorney-client itself.
Okay. I guess I don't understand the difference between
this two. I don't want to split hairs here, but from a standpoint of I'm here, and obviously if there was an attorney-client privilege on matters, and if I knew who the lady was, I probably wouldn't be able to be here to testify. I consulted with another attorney to make sure that I wasn't violating any Kentucky rules. And since I can't remember who the lady is, and B, there was nothing in there. When I referred to the client, I mean generically. I'm not trying to split hairs with you. I'm just trying to be as honest and correct as I can.
Sure, I understand. I don't have clients, so I don't completely understand. That's my confusion there. But you did hear back from a detective, and you did refer this send this information along to Ron Walker at the U.S. Attorney's Office.
I heard back from the detective recently.
Sure.
That's what I testified to. That's correct.
Correct. But the information that you provided, and I think you said that your client did not have any hard information. Is that correct?
You have the email. I don't want to know. I can't tell you whether or not you consider it to be hard information or not. It was information that I provided. As I would do any time I have information I provided, I've been doing that for 34 years of my life.
Okay, and since then, you don't know where the detectives were in their investigation at this period in time?
Emma, other than being asked to come here today, I really have no information as it relates to the case one way or the other.
Okay, so you weren't aware of what they were actually doing and if they were following up on this at all?
I have no idea whatsoever. And I wouldn't suggest they weren't. I've worked with the Lexington Police Department for years. They're good people.
Okay. So, and you wouldn't know what kind of information they had in relation to the information that you sent along?
No, absolutely not.
Okay. That's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Chris Spencer?
Spencer.
Please introduce yourself to the court.
I'm Chris Spencer.
What do you do for a living, Mr. Spencer?
I'm a maintenance superintendent for Department of Highway here in the city.
Are you based out of a specific location with the Department of Highways?
My main office is here in Lexington, and we're on this other road.
May I approach the witness, Your Honor? Recognize that building?
Yes, ma'am.
What is it?
That is our District 7 headquarters.
Okay. Your Honor, I'd like to introduce number
17.
Do you want to use 16
since we get these as
1 and 2? Yes, Your Honor. Where you work?
Yes.
Okay. And specifically, where is it located?
The address is 763 West New Circle Road.
Okay.
It's right in the corner of in Circle and Midtown Pike.
Okay, so in this overhead of the building here, you can see Midtown Court coming this way.
Yes.
Do you know what is just out of the frame here on Midtown Court?
Yes, there's a hotel.
Okay. And can you tell us a little bit about your duties with the Department of Highways and Transportation?
I do all the maintenance for our facilities for District 7. We have 12 counties in the district, including our main office and some highway departments.
Okay. And when you say maintenance, does that include security?
Yes.
Is there, how long have you been in charge of or involved with the security of this building?
Ever since we installed the cameras.
And when was that?
It was January of 2013.
Okay. Now, you mentioned that there were cameras installed in January of 2013. Do you know where those cameras are?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, if I give you a pen, would you be able to mark them?
Yes, I can mark most of them. Some of them want to be off screen in the parking lot.
Okay. And I think you described that you had some cameras in the parking lot?
Yes.
I'm handing you what's been previously admitted as defendant's exhibit 4. Does that show the parking lot?
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's start with this one. This shows the building a little more closely. I'm handing you a pen. Would you be able to mark the security cameras that are on the building on Newtown Court? And I think you indicated, so this one was an error, is that right?
Yes, that was an error.
Just go next to that maybe, or that we don't remember that was the one that was an error. Okay, and then if I could ask you, if you want to go ahead and mark on this one, defense exhibit 4, where those cameras are, which we can show that picture as well. This is the building you were just discussing where you work?
Yes.
Right? And this is the hotel you were mentioning?
Yes.
Okay. So you marked cameras on the building in these locations as well as in the parking lot?
Yes.
So these circles here are the cameras in the parking lot?
Yes.
Are there any cameras in this parking lot?
No.
Okay.
Actually, this camera right here, I'm sorry, it's right here, this is dangerous.
I see. So, at first it was confusing,
yes,
which side?
I was looking for the sidewalk, but I don't see it there.
Okay. And do you know what those cameras look like? Like, actually, when you, you've seen them before?
Yes.
Okay. You mentioned that the cameras were installed in 2012. And were they there in June of 2014?
Yes, ma'am.
How do you ensure that they're working every day?
I have a computer that's in my office that I can get.
Okay. What if there's a problem with the cameras? What do you do?
Then we have to get a contractor and have them fixed.
Okay. Now, the jury's heard a little bit about surveillance cameras and how they work. How are your camera, how is the data from your camera stored?
They are stored on a hard drive on our computer. We have a dedicated hard drive just for those.
Okay, and how long is the data maintained?
They are, we're on a 60-day loop. So every 60 days, it just starts recording from that. It records over the first, so it's got a continuous 60 days on it.
Okay, so if a person was interested in video from June 15th of 2014, how long would that video be available on the hard drive?
Until roughly August.
Until 2 months after?
Yes.
Okay.
Judge, are we on 17?
Yes.
Mr. Spencer, I handed you what's been marked for identification purposes as defendant exhibit 17. What is that a picture of?
That is our camera that's in the parking lot.
Okay. And is that a fair and accurate depiction of that camera as it would have been in June of 2014?
Yes.
Okay. And I'm handing you defendant's exhibit 18.
Let's put 17 up for the jury. So this would be what the camera's on the parking for the parking lot. And what if I handed you defendant's exhibit 18? What is that a photo of?
That's also showing the light poles with the cameras on.
Okay. And is that a fair and accurate depiction of how the cameras would have looked in June of 2014?
Yes.
Okay. So just so we're all clear, what part of that is the camera?
The top part on that one has got the arm, it looks like a little ball, and it gets past the camera.
Okay. How tall are those poles?
Oh gosh. 25, 30 feet maybe.
Okay. Now, can you look and mark for identification purposes of defendant exhibit 19? What is that a picture of?
That also shows our parking lot with the cameras on the boat.
Okay. How many cameras are in this one instead of 19?
There's two.
And it looks like this picture was taken during the day. How many hours a day do your cameras run?
They record whenever there's motion. So anytime there's motion, then the cameras will record until it stops picking up something that's moving.
Even at night?
Even at night, yes.
I'm handing what's been marked for identification purposes as defendant's exhibit 20. What is that a picture of?
That's a picture of the side of the building with the cameras on it.
And is that a fair and accurate depiction of what that camera would look like in June of 2014?
No, actually this camera was added in 2016.
Okay.
But there is one down here on the corner that was in 2014.
Okay, I see. So just to make sure we're, so we talked about this map here with these cameras. And I think you said you wanted to make a change to it?
Yes.
I'll go ahead and let you do that. The ones that you've marked with circles, when were those installed?
All of them except for the one on the front entrance, which would be this one, was installed in 2013.
Okay. And when was that one installed?
2016.
So, and so this picture shows this would be 2013 or 2016.
This would be the 2016, but there's one way down on the corner that is the 2013.
Can you circle the 2013 one for us? So the one that's circled down here is there in 2013?
Yes.
Okay.
Are there any signs saying that there are cameras on your property?
Yes.
When were those signs put up?
They were installed at the same time the cameras were.
Okay, so in 2013?
Yes.
How many signs are there?
I'm not sure. I know there's at least two. We've got one at the rear and one at the front.
And both of those were installed in 2013?
Yes, they were installed at the same time as the cameras.
Commissioner Proce, Mr. John.
So I'm handing you what has been marked for identification purposes as Defendant's Exhibit 21. What have I just handed you?
Picture of our signs.
And is that a fair and accurate depiction of how that sign would have looked in 2014?
Yes.
So that's one of the signs on at the Department of Transportation?
Yes.
Okay, and I'm handing you what's been marked for identification purposes as Defendant's Exhibit 22. What have I just handed you?
It's another picture of one of our other signs.
And is that a fair and accurate depiction of how that sign would have looked in 2014?
Yes.
So, you said there are at least two signs, right?
Yes.
And you know where they are?
Down the roughly, yes.
Okay. So if I gave you this map back, would you be able to mark it on the map?
Yes.
It's okay if you can.
I could probably mark one. The other one, as far as exactly where they mark one, I'm not for sure.
Okay. Well, please mark the one that you're for sure of.
This is the one I'm for sure of.
Okay.
The other one, I believe, is right around here.
Okay. Let's do that for the jury to be able to see. So, and again, just so that we all know where we are, this is Newtown Court here.
Yes.
So, New Circle is, I'm sorry, Newtown Pike, like I-75, is over this way.
Yes.
So if you turn down Newtown Court, you pass the quality and you get to the Department of Transportation.
Yes.
And you indicated, what was this circle again?
That is the sign.
Okay. And where did you think the other sign, if you're without, I don't want to say what you have to
try. I believe it's right around here.
Okay. And if you continue down Newtown Court through the Department of Transportation past your building, where does this road lead?
It just comes into our parking lot, but there is an entrance that goes down onto New Circle Road.
Okay, so if you go, what happens if you drive through the parking lot at this way?
You can go on New Circle Road.
In relation to these buildings, where is the Legacy Trail?
I believe it runs around the back. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Yes, I know there's a walking trail back there. I don't know.
Okay. Are you familiar with the Street Development Drive?
No.
Okay. And you said you've been in charge of security since January 2013?
Yes.
to your recollection, did anyone contact you about getting video from your surveillance system?
Not that I know.
Related to June 15th of 2014?
Not that I know.
Any other attorneys who have questions? Hi, Mr. Spencer.
Hello.
I just have a few questions for you. I think I'm maybe getting a little, I'm just a little off because there are a lot of circles, but I don't know if all of these marks are over the paper, so can I just kind of, can you just kind of clear that for me? Okay. So this is the building where you work?
Yes.
Okay. Is this the front parking lot?
That's the rear parking lot.
That's the rear parking lot?
Yes.
This the rear parking lot?
Yes.
Okay. And so I think you said, let's talk about 2014. What cameras were there in 2014?
All of them except for this one.
Okay. And so how many cameras are on this side of the building?
One. Showing the rear parking lot.
Is it that?
Yes.
Okay. And do you have pictures of the actual cameras? Did you check them?
No.
But is that what the cameras look like?
Yes.
And then that one? I think there was one, right? Is that the camera we're referring to?
That's the one that was installed in 2016, yes.
Oh, that's the one in 2016. So do we have a picture of the one that was in the back of the building in 2014?
No.
Okay, we don't see that one?
No.
Okay. And we don't have a picture of the range, I guess. Does that make sense, like how far out that camera?
No, we do not.
Is it? Okay. Can you, so would this camera record necessarily back here?
Yes, you can see the report.
Okay, you can. It's just, is this going to be better detailed up here than it would be?
Yes.
Back here? Okay. Can you see over the quality in wall?
No.
And is this a tree line here?
Yes.
Okay. And what direction do these, does this have a direction or is it, can you see all of this area?
It's aiming directly at the rear parking lot.
It's aiming directly?
Yes, so that you can see that whole area.
Okay. And is that the same for, do these point the same direction? Which direction would be?
No. This one here.
Okay.
Points to this driveway so that you can see if you're coming down.
Okay.
This one points up the sidewalk so we can see who's coming into the building.
Okay.
And these point, you know, these lines of traffic are cars. So we can see the whole, this whole parking lot.
Okay, and this is not a camera?
No, that is a sign.
That's one of the signs. Where's the other sign?
It's out here.
Back over here?
Yes.
Okay. And are there any cameras back here?
Yes, there's two cameras.
Those two cameras?
Yes.
And there's also a sign? Okay, but those cameras pointing to this parking lot?
Yes.
Okay, so there wouldn't be anything off to this that would show a corner here? Is that correct? Okay. Just one second. That's all I have. Thank you.
So
So we were just talking about the camera that's on this side. And you said this is the camera?
There's one on the back side, or the back part.
Okay, so that would be on the back side.
This one.
This one, okay, I'm so sorry, I'm a little, okay, so, and this camera, you said captures the entire parking lot?
Yes.
Okay. And this is a picture here of that.
Yes.
So I guess it casts a pretty wide, you could say, for security, just to make sure everything's safe in the building, right?
I'm going to talk to you on.
Thank you, Mr. Twister, how are you?
Mr. Chairman, we need to introduce the head of the exhibits.
And the 6 pages, 23, we have to go down.
Karen, can we approach briefly? The defense is called Joshua Cow.
Do you swear or affirm the testimony you give here today will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, sir?
Yes, I will.
You go around and have to sit down with the witness stand with your office.
Josh, can you please state your name for the record?
My name is Joshua Powell.
And how are you employed?
An investigator with the Public Defender's Office, the Capital Trials Branch, in Lexington.
And can you briefly describe your career path prior to becoming an investigator for our office?
How far back? Where did you go?
Just brief.
I joined the military in the year 2000. I served as a military police officer for roughly 12 years. I have a bachelor's degree in criminal justice, a master's degree in criminology, and I attended the Department of Criminal Justice Training Academy in Richmond. And then I was a police officer for 7 years. From 2007 to 2014.
And is that when you came to the Public Defender's Office?
Yes, ma'am.
Were you assigned to work on the Lyme Malazan's case?
Yes.
Typically, what are your duties when you're assigned to a case?
Most of my duties, we receive discovery from the prosecution, police reports, autopsy reports, any kind of report that's out there. And it's my job to investigate for the subject who's accused of those crimes.
So would your duties also include things like serving subpoenas, taking photos, interviewing witnesses?
Yes. Regards to a robbery which occurred at the Quality Inn on June 15, 2014.
And specifically with Ms. Hansberg, were you serving a subpoena? What were you doing?
Mostly as a subpoena for a court hearing we were having.
Did you record your conversation that you had with Ms. Hansberg that day?
Yes, ma'am.
And what do you use to record your conversation?
It's your average digital recorder that most police officers, investigators have.
Do you have it with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Can we see it? You're not recording right now, right?
Nope.
And is that the recorder or a recorder like that that you use to record your conversation with Ms. Hansberg?
Yes.
When you we're recording that conversation, where was the recorder located?
I believe it was in wintertime when I spoke with Ms. Hansford, and usually I would just have it in the front pocket, and it'd be covered with a jacket, especially in wintertime.
When do you typically start your recording device when you're meeting with a witness?
I try to start it approximately a minute or two before I approach the subject. Usually I'm in my car, which you'll hear singing at the very beginning. Just, I like to start. start the recorder before you approach the subject so there's no question about you starting your recorder late.
Okay. Your Honor, at this point, the defense would move to play a recording of a brief interview with Ms. Hanser. Witnesses when
reading
the pocket recorder, do you find that the sound is obscure?
Never had that happen before. There's been interviews, rain, snow. The interview with Ms. Hanser, I think, was outside.
During your work on this case, have you become familiar with what Antonio Taylor looks like?
Yes.
You're a man of course, a witness. I'm going to show you what has previously been marked as Defendant's Exhibit Number 9. I'm going to be introducing that part. But do you recognize that photo?
Yes, ma'am.
And who's that photo of?
That is Antonio Taylor.
And is there an indication on when that photo was taken?
Pretty sure this one was 2016. Yes.
Your Honor, at this point, I will introduce. It was previously marked as Defense Exhibit 9, so now it'll be introduced as 9. In this case, did you travel to the quality inn?
Yes.
And what did you do at the quality inn?
I took some videos, some photos, did some measurements, and after reading the police reports, I kind of followed the path that K-9 took, just researched the area for the most part. Walkway towards room 115, and this would be the back of the building.
And who took these photos?
I did. Right where the card is actually, she was cleaning 114 at that time.
And what is this area that you've been standing in when you took the photo?
This is the exits here, and there's a driveway which goes behind the hotel. There's a grassy area which would be down this way. This is room 115 right here, and this is just a photo the opposite way of which we were just looking.
And you indicated that you took some measurements while you were there.
Yes,
what
ma'am.
What sort of measurements did you take?
I did feet from 115, which ended actually two distance, right to the edge of the sidewalk, which was 119 feet, and just to the grassy area was 165 feet.
And how are you measuring this?
I have a roller, which all law enforcement agencies use.
And did you take any videos while you were there?
Yes.
What sort of video did you take?
Starting from room 115, I did a video on my phone, just walking at an average pace down this way.
And did you time that?
Yes.
And how long did it take you to walk from room 115 down to the end?
Approximately 35 seconds.
Now, we have a video of that. We'd move to play that video. And right before you stop the video and show us your watch, what are we seeing there?
Straight ahead, you see the grass and trees, and right across that would be the DOT building. Yes, I did.
Okay. And where was that?
It was on Dominican Drive in Lexington, Kentucky.
Okay. So we previously heard the testimony that her address was 493 Dominican Drive. You went there?
Yes.
Okay. I have a map that's about 3 feet too big for trying to establish where she lives, but somebody did a good job making it, so I'll go ahead and use it. Too big for what we're doing here, but this has been marked as defendant's exhibit. Okay, take a look at this map here and orient yourself. Now, you know Dominican Drive to be in the St. Martin's Village neighborhood?
Yes.
Okay, can you kind of tell what you're doing with where it's at?
Just trying to orient myself.
It's okay. So we have, this is New Circle Road up here going through.
Is this Georgetown Street?
So this is Newtown Pike.
Okay, this is Georgetown Street.
Georgetown Street.
Okay, so it'll be right here.
Okay, so in here?
Yeah.
All right. And like you said, this is Newtown Pike?
Yes.
And this is New Circle?
Yes.
All right. Like I said, far too big for that, but there you go. That's all the questions that I have to. So move to it now.
Your Honor, if we can approach briefly.
Mr. Powell, I just have a couple of questions for you.
Yes, ma'am. Hello.
And you said that you were a police officer from 2007 to 2014?
Yes.
Here in Lexington?
At the UK Police Department.
Oh, UK. Okay. And then at UK, were you like a patrol officer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And what jurisdiction does UK have? Just UK area?
Pretty much it's all UK-owned buildings and any street adjacent to any street where UK has property.
And then you were shown a picture of Antonio Taylor. Have you ever met him? Have you ever seen him?
No, I've seen a video of him.
Just a video of him?
Yes.
You've never talked to him in person?
No, I haven't.
Okay. And then that photo was from 2016, correct?
Not yes, ma'am.
2014?
2016, yes.
Okay. And so having never met him, you don't know what he looked like in 2014?
I've seen other looking photos.
I'm talking about in person. You've never seen him?
Never seen him in person.
In 2014?
No, ma'am.
Okay. And then, did Ms. Hansford know that you were recording her?
Don't think so.
Okay. Do you, you kind of showed your recorder earlier. Do you know what kind of recorder that Detective Upchurch has?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Do you know what he was wearing when he went to go meet Ms. Hansford to show the lineup?
Probably his typical detective uniform, which would be a suit.
Okay, but you don't know?
No, ma'am.
Okay. All right. And then when you met with Ms. Hansford, did you go by yourself?
Yes.
And then just kind of last questions. When you were doing that video, when you were walking down the, I guess that path or whatever, you don't know how fast or slow the, when the victims were talking about these two defendants coming up to them, you don't know how fast or slow that they were walking you.
No, ma'am, I just walked at a average pace.
Okay, and you didn't take the victims out and walk with you to walk how fast or slow that was either?
At the time of the video, I had no more contact with the victims.
Okay. That's all I have.
Thank you.